good friends no matter where we are. So, you know, it's great to see him doing well as well. So, yeah, a little rival. I can't really sledge him because he'll just laugh at me. You know, he's that kind of guy. So, no, it'll be great fun playing each other and, yeah, looking forward to it.
He really is that kind of guy. The first match, TKR won. Congratulations. Good start. But you got out to a blinder. What, did you look back at that catch by Brandon King?
Yeah, I saw that sometimes you just got to take your hat off. You know, not much you can do about it. You know, it was a great catch, so we got to give it to him. But, you know, it was great to just get out there and get the win for TKR, you know, with my first game. So it was real good to get the win.
All right. Well, all to do today. You're coming up against the Jamaica Talawas. Any plans, team strategy?
No, just kind of do what we did the other day. You know, just fight. They're a great team. You know, they've got some massive power hitters. So if we just do our plans, then hopefully it'll be better than them. But, yeah, so hopefully we can go 2 from 2 and hopefully the weather stays away and we'll hopefully get a game in.
Thanks, Tim. Go well.
No worries. Thank you very much.
Alex Jordan talking to Tim Seifert, and he's got very impressive mic technique as well. Career in the media beckons as the sun goes down. Far too many New Zealanders are wrong for my liking. Danny Morrison is sitting next to me. Danny, welcome. How much are you looking forward to this contest?
Good to be here, Bish. All the way from Aotearoa. You know you love us Kiwis. But when I look at it, yeah, the weather has been unfortunate, but that happens. And it is after all the rainy season, Bish. Chatting to you guys, local weatherman alongside me, you just got to get on with it. You got to suck it up and just say, hey, look, this is what can happen. Thankfully, we're playing at this great venue that does drain exceptionally well. I've been very impressed with that, and I've been very impressed with the ground staff, how much they've worked so cohesively together. And Dave Agnew's been here out from Australia, but he's based in New Zealand. So helping, and they're getting it all together because it allows these gentlemen out in the middle to get out and show their wares. So looking forward to it.
Yeah, the home franchise is on display here tonight, and of course the entire thing, tournament taking place in Trinidad and Tobago, and we're very thankful to the government and the authorities for allowing us to host this great tournament. Of course, Trinidad and Tobago famous for its carnival, and many will be hoping that it does take place in 2021. The steel band obviously has been a great part of the culture and the history of this wonderful nation, twin island state of Trinidad and Tobago. And you get down to the west in Chagaramus and you get to the bamboo walks, and of course the hub of business activity and sport right here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy in South Trinidad. You can get to zip lining in the greenery of the western peninsula of the country. Such an ethnic mix. Worth a visit when borders reopen down the road. And of course, the Bravo brothers are here, Dwayne and Darren, critical parts of the cricket history of this country as much as Sunil Narine. In many ways, a franchise player, has played for the Amazon Warriors. And Tim Seifert, Danny, with Brendan McCullum as the coach, the head man of TKR. What is the influence you're expecting throughout this tournament of him?
Well, of course, with Baz McCullum having played so recently and now turning his hand to coaching, and as Tim Seifert said in that lovely little feature piece there with Alex Jordan, that, you know, you look up and you have mentors and role models and guys that you aspire to do that sort of performance. Yeah, the ump's out in the middle with the Hero Plinth, got the match ball, Zahid Basarath, Gregory Brathwaite are out in the middle, Nigel Duguid is upstairs. We're looking forward to this. Yeah, and I just think he packs a punch like that. You know, he's a very good keeper in terms of white ball cricket, and he loves to go at the top of the innings. As you mentioned with Alex, he's also in recent times come a little bit more in the middle order, whether it's, you know, batting at 4 or 5, and to change his game somewhat. He's got a great coach, as he mentioned there. Nice to have Brendan McCullum around. As I say, he's played so recently and knows the feel the rhythm of 2020 cricket.
Well, the experience of Chadwick Walton didn't fire in the first game, but there's such a great depth of power hitting in this very skillful Jamaica Talawas team. And the changes were kind of interesting that were made on both teams, because you could see why Carey Pearce came in, left-arm spinner looking to take the ball away from a predominantly right-handed batting lineup for the Talawas. But with the moisture in the field, I wonder how that impacts him. And Fidel Edwards, with all his experience and pace, we'll see him later with Romar Lewis, the off-spinner, because of the number of left-handers that TKR present.
I always love it when the players, you've got them at the coin toss piece, and, you know, they're not doing what they're, you know, the coin toss has gone against them. Oh, no, that's okay. We're happy doing it, really. In these conditions, obviously, you want to bowl first because of the DLS method, as we've just seen. In fact, in match five, but here's Glenn Phillips, another Kiwi acquisition, young man, been here for a few seasons now, three in fact, yeah, so he does like to get things moving. We've got a nice little 44 in the previous outing.
His little brother as well, Dale, I think, that has played some cricket, but for now the focus is on Chadwick Walton, who he himself had to bat in the middle order, I think, when he played at the Bangladesh Premier League and the PSL recently, and did quite well. But at the top is where his best game has been. Ali Khan of the USA, hoping to get some swing and that early breakthrough, which has become a staple of his. So here we go, final countdown. Hold on to your seats across the Caribbean region, across the globe. Can Ali Khan find that outswing? There's a slip and a gully in place. Deep square and the third man, the two men outside of a circle. On target.
Yeah, it's so important here for Ali Khan, because he was just a little bit off, and understandably, first outing, and the radar slightly out of kilter. These regular faces in this powerful TKR lineup. Let's see if these two powerful Jamaican Talawas opening batters can get hold of stuff.
Chance. He does it so often, Ali Khan, getting that wicket with a new ball. An El Dorado celebration. He really has been an acquisition over the years for TKR.
Well, only the second delivery of this innings. Chadwick Walton's got to go. Big leading edge. Didn't go very far at all for a moment. I thought it might have gone down to Munro on the boundary. Forward Ahmed. Pouch is a very comfortable skier. As the sun sets here in Trinidad and Tobago. Out for a duck is Chadwick Walton. It's none for one.
That's a gift Till Phillips, and that's the one area where he's stronger than maybe any other place, hitting into that leg side. Hero Maximum.
Yeah, get the tunes amping, because we love it there on the hip ball. Do opening batters. Oh yeah, got it horribly wrong there, Ali Khan. And got what it deserved.
It's an interesting shot replay that we saw from down the line, because it told us how far across the off stump Glenn Phillips comes with his trigger. Does that mean then that Ali Khan has to maybe shift his intentional line, which ideally he would want to be an off stump, maybe a fourth or fifth stump? Yeah, just about there. Just about there.
Nice, Bish, yeah. Right on, spot on. It is that length, and even though batsmen in the modern era, and when we were playing in that 20th century, Bish, batsmen that have that trigger and just slide across off stump. His is very pronounced, isn't it? But there's that searching length. It doesn't matter how good a player you are, you hit those areas and you're going to ask questions on off stump or just outside early on. And, Lee Carmen, he does get it right, and a little bit of outswing with a slingish action, hence the slip in. He gets that rhythm cruising in a nice gear, and he can be a handful.
Man has gone back on the boundary at point. Excellent, excellent. One went away, the ball before. Now this one is perhaps touched down on the same line and nipped back.
Yeah, like that with Glenn Phillips with his tongue out. How do you play that? Oh, it's come back appreciably. Really has. Cut him in half. Watch this. Oh! Talk about Mick Jaggage. That's a beauty.
And he would know all about that, Fidel Edwards, grand old age. What is he now, 37, 38? That's a good shot. That really is a top-class shot from Glenn Phillips. From outside the off stump. Yeah, Bravo agrees, 10 for 1.
So the back lift here. Drops down. That little flick, isn't it? Just a little punch of that bottom hand, that's all. Yeah, that's right, Ali Khan. Can't believe it either. Heck. Ten off the first. Knight Riders will be pretty happy because they got rid of the dangerous Chadwick Walton. There's Seals. Oh, what a beauty. Goal given, yeah, first ball. LBW, you know it. It's an LLBW. What a lovely celebration to go with a top delivery. Want to look at this down the line, and so do the coaching staff of Jamaica. Pitched on, yeah, that's a beauty.
That is a serious delivery. That is serious. It had to pitch on, as Danny Morrison said, and then it nipped back, and perhaps the pace on it as well, skidding for second wicket in CPL cricket for Jaden Seals, 18 years old. And so many people, including myself, think that there's a bright future for this kid. Maybe sometimes in the future for Curtin as well. He goes for naught, 10 for 2.
Already two down, the Jamaica Talawas. Inside the power play, let alone in the second over. A couple of ducks at the top here. Phillips is a bit like Johnson Charles earlier in match five, got all the runs early. Mates at the other end. Need to head back to the pavilion. Seals. Good zip. I think with all that rain around too, Bish, covers on for a long time this afternoon. Here we are, local time, 10 past 6. Look at this, yeah, beauty. Pitches on, straightens enough. Just skids on a bit. Good pace. Caught on the crease, back leg. Height maybe, but when you see it front on, that's the thing. Remember, the umps only get one look at it. And it's a split second. It happens very quickly with the fast men. So you can understand why Curtin had to go. What? Just stand and deliver and swat this. It's not going to go. It's just pitched and plugged a little. I think it was more toe end of the bat, but just stands there. Rodman Powell, dismissive. That. Oh, yeah, width on offer. What a beat. Time it, of course, but tensions. Positive as ever.
Good think. Having used the short ball, no problems with that, but Seals could probably go back to that three-quarter length on off stump. Right there.
Every time you're coming on just asking for something, you're getting it, baby. Getting it. That is a peach. Oh, down the line. Here we go. And there we go. Oh, that's such a great length. Oh, lovely seam position, good wrist. Gorgeous.
You know, one of the things I like about him, and Lungi Ngidi's South African fastball is probably in bed right now, South African time, but he reminds me a lot of Lungi Ngidi's action, but a lot of the energy going towards its target. He doesn't waste the energy. You look at the follow through. It's right down the offside of the pitch, and that tells me the alignment is pretty good. Everything driving towards his intended target at 18 years of age. Brilliant.
100%. Go to coaching clinics, you do lots of analysis on youngsters. You and I certainly have. And that lovely lean forward. And you think of the great fast bowlers in the 20th century leaning forward and conserving energy but having great rhythm. Look at this athlete. Oh, that is tasty. After all the deliveries he's been facing, he's been smoked for a hero maximum. Talk about a life boy clean strike. Holy moly, two done. It's 18 for two.
No shame in this. Rodman Powell is a good player of that short ball. But Seals has done a terrific job in picking up a wicket. That is beautiful. The Gulf of Paria. And of course, the highway that leads north-south to the right of your screen. And when the crowds come back eventually, this place is a hive of activity.
Absolutely brilliant. Really does hum here. It only holds about 15 or 16,000. But geez, when it's chocker and you've of course got the vibe and the music and the dances and everything that goes with that, really is an intimate stadium. Good big playing surface. But you do feel the crowd when you're down there. Players thrive on it. Here's Ellie Carnegie. Good length. Seals, you say 18. You always sort of question coach, then you say, look at his agent. These guys are strong and bearded from an early age.
I enjoyed talking to his dad a lot in South Africa. The families came out to follow the West Indies under 19, and it's a familiar name because where I live in Port of Spain, where I grew up in St. Anne's, there was a gentleman by the name of Derek Seals who is a musician, sings a lot of music, and I just wonder if that's a relation of Jaden and his family as well. But for everything that I've heard about Jaden and the people that work with him, they talk about a superb work ethic. He said, in fact, when I saw him at the under-19s, he said, I'm wondering how I'll go this year because I really, before the pandemic, I really want to do my schoolwork. I'm really strong into that and I want to finish it. So he was kind of torn in between. So it tells you a lot about that kid.
Yeah, got the smarts, got the work ethic. Here is some shape. Then it's also, if you're saying about the musical background, and it could be in the DNA, look at the rhythm. Got the rhythm, man. And certainly did with his run-up. Beautiful. Smooth approach.
Something is wrong with you, bro.
Always. That's nothing new. Oh, we love it here. In the West Indies. A little bit of a heave. Hack. So, yeah, just trying to get hard hands, fast hands through it.
Yeah, and I was looking at that shot and the shot before of the footwork of Glenn Phillips, and maybe he hasn't gotten into the innings yet, but it's just, I think two balls are good. The feet don't go anywhere, just the hands go at the ball. And even the one that followed that, the last delivery, it was missed time because, again, I think the feet didn't quite go. So maybe until he does something special with those outside there, I'd be inclined to bowl to earn the wider side, off stump side.
I also think you've got to give credit to the bowler, Bish, don't you? They found a lovely searching length, both these youngsters. Oh, that! It's out! Oh, good stuff! Who's that? Is that DJ? Get on the dance floor and let's have an Eldorado celebration. That is a rippy. Made ground and all of a sudden the ball dips on you, dies on you because it's been miscued. This time from the skipper, Rovman Powell. What a good take. Good athleticism from DJ Bravo.
Republic Bank Classic. It maybe just straightened on Rovman Powell a touch, and that's why it took almost a leading edge and a little bit of flavor added to the catch from Dwayne Bravo. He took off a little bit late, but Ali Khan has been a foot soldier for TKR in the years that he's been here. Looks like a pitch that needs some circumspection initially. Powell goes for eight, 19 for three.
Savali. Yeah, it runs in the last outing for Talawaz. Yeah, with you, Ian Bishop. Need some circumspection. You really have to have a good look and settle in here as a batter. Well, not to that. Oh, yeah. And the follow through. A nice little glare and a wink. But yeah, both these youngsters. Good rhythm. A couple of scratchy ones early on from Ali Khan, but now he's found his rhythm. He's found his straps. That's a beauty. Good line, good height. Yeah, and it's just that lovely bit of zip off the surface when you do find that back end of a good length. Certainly, Powell needed to just, as a captain, a little bit more wary, given there's still a bit of the power play to go. Slip's just gone a little bit wider. Solitary slip. Oh, yeah, pace, and he's only just clocked this. Going to come back for two. Easy.
21 for three. It's a critical over, I think, in the balance of power with Phillips, who I think will go hard at anything loose. Still not finding his timing, whether that's his rhythm on the day or the pitch itself might be a bit too paced.
Quite a few of the players have said that, haven't they, over the course of the last 2 days. Just a fraction too paced. And again, understandably so. A lot of the cricket being played anywhere. A little bit in the UK, of course, some test cricket, but of late, no. And we've had this weather that's been around, as we all know, in this part of the world. We just spice things up and you get that length. And other times it just doesn't quite arrive.
Thinking the other day when Asif Ali was making that well-constructed 47 from 27. I shouldn't say constructed, but he was giving that blitz. I was wondering about his back foot game. If he came up against good pace, he looked good on the back foot the other day, and that's a sign of good players. I was wondering when he came into the competition and came up whether they'd go short and just be able to test him out. We've seen two short balls from Ali Khan already to him very early.
That homework, definitely. They would have looked at that innings. Miles away from this one, Glenn Phillips. What a cracker. Might have died a little bit too, but geez, he was miles away from this delivery. Try and heave it over on the offside. What's this? Oh, yeah. Yeah, of course, you know that footage is so available. Watching and analysing and seeing what a guy does in one particular inning, so a previous one in particular, and then say, hey, this is where we're going to go, change things up a little bit against this guy. That is clean, and that's what he's looking for, Glenn Phillips. 15 from 11, striking at 136. Yeah, it felt good. Don't worry, young man, if you keep going and running in and getting that lovely length you got most of the time this evening, you're in with a chance. It's just a very, very good stroke. Radar's just got lost a little bit there. And you saw that from Ali Khan, where Phillips dispatched it for sixth. This time, the biggest side of the ballpark. It's a full toss nonetheless and disappears very quickly for four.
And again, I'll say that Kyron Pollard and Dwayne Bravo will know a hand around the shoulder or a gentle word to Jaden Steele saying, that's okay. You're up against a good young international player in Glenn Phillips. It's a slightly wet ball now, so control maybe a little harder to come by, and this is your learning environment. already taken a wicket, so just keep persevering. Touched 141 so far in this game. Ideally, he wants that fourth stump maybe again, but the length critical. Good length. No slip now. That's it. Exactly right there. Exactly right there. 29 for three after four.
Last ball. Oh, jagged a little bit as well, but it did keep a little low. Yeah, look at Phillips. Just saying, it's just died and skidded. Also with a little bit of movement off the seam. Truly is a gorgeous time of a late afternoon, early evening with the sun setting here. South Trini. Match six. Slightly delayed start here if you've just tuned in. The Jamaica Talawas were inserted because Kyron Pollard won the toss. It will field first. Here's Carey Pierre. Ah, good to see him. Left arm orthodox. Drops this one a little short. Loosener to get going. So he's come into the side.
Yeah, and particularly because it's such a right-handed heavy batting lineup. Apart from Curtin, there won't be much spin for Carey Pierre on this surface. He generally bowls wicket to wicket. Nice. Nice. That's a nice, easy, clean, straight hit from Asif Ali.
Oh, bonsoir. Just disappeared that for another maximum. Clean and straight as. Very nice. Asif Ali likes that, likes this pace, likes that length.
For that reason, I know Pollard is looking to spread his use of particularly Ali Khan. I just wonder if it was worth a punt in having another over since Asif Ali was on strike at the start. Whether he could have squeezed another one out of Ali Khan.
Yeah, I concur. I think so, because he's just got in. He's now double figures, but he wasn't a moment ago. So I just wonder whether Pollard could have gone with that. Sometimes you stick with one guy and he's going well. Particularly with the new seed and bouncing guys and setting the rhythm of a new guy at the crease. Well done, KP.
Remember when he got player of the final here 2 years ago, Carey Pierre? He took that marvellous return catch, provides energy in the field.
Always been a big fan. Nicknamed the Frenchman. Had to.
By you.
And the Spice Man. Double O behave. So we've had five, and Jamaica are 40 for three here.
Another change in the bowling. The magician Sunil Narine. That's what has happened so far. 40 for three. Been put under some early pressure here. The Jamaica Talawas. Walton, Curtin and Powell. Batsmen to have been dismissed. So a wonderful start for the Trinbago Knight Riders in this contest. Second match of the doubleheader here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. Ryan didn't play any sort of competitive cricket since last year's CPL. What we saw in that first match, he didn't show any sign of rustiness. And half century and two wickets as well. Somewhat of a new action, just hiding the ball. So in that first encounter. Ow! On the other end of the spectrum, Asif Ali. He had a wonderful start to his CPL career. Not out, says the umpire Tom Moody. How do you reckon this particular contest will go? Still Narayan against Asif Ali.
Well, it's always an intriguing one, isn't it? Whenever Narayan's got the ball in his hand, Asif Ali wouldn't have seen a lot of Sunil Narayan. But like a lot of Asian players, they have an ability to adapt to unique spin. They're sort of brought up on a diet of a variety of spin. So it's going to be intriguing to see his approach.
Huge shot down the leg side. A good take by Tim Seifert. Not out the call. Just angling down that leg side, clearly off the thigh pad. Good decision there from the umpire. By Zaid Basrat, who hails from St. Mary's Village in Muruga, not too far from here. Tom, if you put on your coaching cap, you're the coach of a team, you come up against Sunil Narayan, you've not played him before, what's your message to your batsman?
Good luck. Yeah, look, I think it's very individual, that. Now, everyone's got a different approach against spin, everyone's got a different method to prepare for a tournament or a match against certain opposition. So it's trying to provide and facilitate the resources for that player to be prepared as best as possible, whether that's providing a lot of vision for them or giving them as much practice as possible. Or just say, go for the long handle and hit a hero maximum. And that's how Asif Ali's going to deal with it. It's the end of the sixth over. It's 46 for three.
Magnificent shot here from Asif Ali. After five dot balls, he decided to give it a go. And good connection there from the Pakistani international. Absolutely smoked that one. Really magnificent image there. Sun setting, western coast. Trinidad and Tobago, the end of the Guardian Live power play, and 46 for three. So in terms of runs, not too bad. Their concern would be that three wickets they've lost. Carey Pair will continue from the northern end here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. So it's spin from both ends. Asif Ali will be more adept at playing these type of bowlers. A little bit more used to clinicians. Glenn Phillips, of course, has been here for a few seasons. And this one is smashed through the offside. Chase one for Colin Monroe. Excellent effort. But in the end, it goes to the boundary. A magnificent shot there from Glenn Phillips with an offer. And absolutely smashed. 50 up for the Talawas.
Such a powerful player, Phillips. He's done a lot of work off-season. to build up his strength, and you can see that with his stroke play. He really crunches it. Very, very exciting young player. Also can keep wicket. Haven't seen him do that so far in this Hero CPL, but he's a very capable keeper, and when he's not keeping, he's more than useful in the outfield.
Just to follow up on that, he's been the leading scorer for the Jamaica Talawas for the last two seasons. Remember that magnificent century he got in a playoff match against the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots down in Guyana on a very tricky pitch. El Dorado Sky Cam taking off, producing those wonderful images that we've been seeing. Really idyllic. I wonder too, Tom, and we've seen really torrential rain here at this facility earlier today. How will that impact the spinners who we have on show? And this one is smashed through the offside. Chase on again for Colin Monroe. Not enough power this time to get it to the boundary, but certainly some intent from Asif Ali.
Yeah, there's no doubt it's going to have a big bearing on the spinners playing in today or this evening's match, and you'd know better than anyone, being a former spinner, it just makes it very difficult to get a consistent grip on the ball. And instead of giving it the real rip that you want to give it, end up putting the ball there. But really your only variation becomes pace against pace and spin. Is that how you see it?
Yeah, absolutely. So you become more a defensive type bowler in these conditions as opposed to attacking. When you really want to go looking for wickets, you have to just dress back just a little and try to get out of your overs as much as possible. And Pravin Tambi, he has a lot of experience. 48-year-old, making his CPL debut. First Indian to play in the Hero CPL. I played with him in Rajasthan Royals in 2013. Tom Moody, so some memories from that. At the end of seven overs, 55 for three. So good going for the Jamaica Talawas in terms of runs. 26, 19 for Phillips. The bowlers used so far. Well, Ali Khan, he's been impressive as usual, picking up those two early wickets. Equally impressive, if not more, Jaden Seals, 1 for 16. Two spinners in operation so far, Pierre and Sunil Narayan. Sunil Narayan back on.
So you mentioned Rajasthan Royals, that 2013 you played with Pravin Tambi, so that makes you 48 or 58? Come on, mate.
I'm not going to give out that information, Tom Moody.
Just on a serious note, on Tambi, he's a serious bowler still. He really is. I know a lot of people will be shocked to hear of his age, but I tell you what, if he gets his chance, which he could well do, he will not let anyone down.
So a nice partnership building between these two, 37 of 28. Consolidating after the loss of those three early wickets. Karen Pollard already indicating to the umpires moisture on the ball, perhaps some swelling. A very cagey character, this man.
Well, the umpires will be very aware it's going to be challenging for both teams. So they'll try to be as consistent as possible, and they'll mark down the actual time in the innings that they do change the ball, and they'll try to replicate that in the second innings.
Asif Ali, really impressed with him in the first match. I played with him too in the PSL Tom Moody for Islamabad United. Played with quite a few of these players here, but his stats, the 100 batsmen who have scored 1,000 plus runs in T20 cricket since 2018, but only four of them have done it with a strike rate of 160 plus. Andrew Russell, 183, Moeen Ali, Phil Salt, and Asif Ali, 161. So it really does make an impact when given the opportunity. And here the wickets that have fallen so far. The first one, Chadwick Walton, just getting a thick leading edge. A simple catch for forward Ahmed. Nicholas Kilton, first ball. Magnificent delivery there from Jaden Seals. And Ali Khan again. This time the captain, Rothman Powell. And look at that. Dynamism from Dwayne Bravo. So some early setbacks here for the JTs. Decent partnership building. Of course, Andrew Russell, Carlos Brathwaite in the sheds. So you'd expect some fireworks later on. So he'd be very confident, especially after that wonderful innings in the first game. This is a concern for me, for the spinners. Finger spinners, you can argue, have it a little bit easier. Of course, they won't admit it. Look at that action. Yeah! And he's bowled him. Another wicket. And that man again, Sunil Narine, making an impact. Despite the conditions here, despite the wet ball, still finding a way.
Yeah, quicker delivery. It's up around 95 kilometres, that one, so a lot quicker through the air. Skidded off the surface, hiding the delivery. Didn't want to let anything, any hint at all to the batsman. And that's just hurried off the surface and turned in ever so slightly. So very, very well bowled. It's the end of Asif Ali. He goes for 22 from 16. It's 58 for 4.
Carlos Brathwaite, new batsman for the Jamaica Talawas, making a move from the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. So his first season with the JTs. Wonderful strike rate of over 140. He'll have to navigate this final delivery from the 8th over from Narine. Safely plays that one at the end of 8 overs, 58 for 4.
TKR will be happy with the four wickets. They know very well there's depth in this Talawar's batting lineup. Well, it's a good opportunity for Carlos Brathwaite to get some time out in the middle. So often players like him are power players, only tend to come in after about the 15th, 16th over, but he's got plenty of time to get himself set and really build, in the context of T20 cricket, a substantial innings. The Ryan in action here. The interesting thing with Sunil Narine, from time to time he does hide that ball behind his back, just to keep the batsman guessing. Does it more to his fellow countrymen than others? People are more familiar with his bowling. Forward Ahmed into the attack. And speaking of wrist spinners, well, he may have a little bit more difficulty holding this damp ball. Excellent record in Hero CPL.
Yes, and speaking of that record, Tom Moody, 22 wickets 2 years ago. The leading wicket taker in 2018 in the Hero CPL. Didn't have a particularly good first game, none for 26 off three. And again, difficult conditions here in terms of the moisture in the field. But not a bad time to be bowling at 59 for four into the ninth over. So you're not under any real pressure. Batsmen won't be coming after you. So you can settle in, get a feel of the surface, and then pull out this bag of tricks. I think that's going to be a familiar theme throughout the night. That wet ball, players complaining.
That was fine. That wasn't perfectly delivered, Rongan. Seems to be okay at the moment.
The only thing with this, Rongan, was the line was a little bit too wide, so that Carlos Brathwaite was able to navigate it quite easily. Ideally, if Fawad Ahmed bowls this very close, so it finishes on the stump, let those LBWs bowl down into play. So still maybe not the 100% control that he would want, but he bowls that delivery quite regularly. It's an attacking delivery, a wicket-taking delivery. At the end of nine overs, the Talawar was 59 for four. Almost at the halfway mark of the first innings in this contest. Keep mentioning this TKR outfit spoiled for choices. Dwayne Bravo, evergreen, and a further sent Dwayne Bravo into the attack. Two wickets away from achieving 500 wickets in T20 cricket. I'm the only bowler to have achieved that feat, and certainly you'd expect him to get there, if not in this match, certainly in this year's Hero CPL. Pollard just taking his time, ensuring that everything is exactly how he wants it. So some movements are wrong still, just directing traffic, really. Right, so finally, we're about to go again. Fine leg back, third man up. Dwayne Bravo around the wicket.
Discussions leading into this contest, how to bowl that to that man in the screen, Andre Russell. He's given a lot of teams massive headaches over the years. He's really turned himself into such a destructive middle order player in this format. Everyone's got their own theories, everyone's got their options, preferred options, that is bowling options, whether that is spin, whether it is left arm pace or right arm pace or short deliveries or bowling at his ankles. He's found a way over the last few years to conquer everything that's thrown at him. He's only 32, so he's still got so much more to offer.
Just to follow up on that, Tom Moody, he's had two centuries against the Trinbago Knight Riders. So it's really a happy hunting opponent for this man. And they too, the Trinbago Knight Riders, would be wary and very conscious of that. So with him still in the sheds, they know that this game is still on. One is up in the air, someone's getting under it. Gary Pierre almost, we know how magnificent he is in the field. Lots of room out there. Unfortunately, for Glenn Phillips, it fell in the gap.
Yeah, Phillips picking the slower ball and trying to launch that over mid-wicket for six, just not getting the timing. Gary Pierre had to cover a lot of ground to track that down. Also gives us an indication how wet it is in the outfield with that dive. Very, very damp, and it's only going to get harder and harder for the men in the field.
Dwayne Bravo a bit expensive in the first game. Just four runs in his first over. So many senior players in this Trinbago Knight Riders team, very skillful. That ball to end the over. Look at that from Tim Seifert, trying to get the better of his countryman. That's commitment there. Stumps on the ground, all three stumps on the ground at the end of 10 overs. It's the Angostura LLB drinks break, 63 for 4, the Jamaica Tallawas.
Walton and Curtin not troubling the scorers. Glenn Phillips, as usual, a symbol of consistency for this Stalowers team. He's got a newcomer to the crease, Carlos Brathwaite, but a lot of work still to do with the bat. Just shift in focus. The Twin Island Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, the beauty that it is. Capital city of Port of Spain, the business hub of the island. And you can enjoy the diversity of the flora and fauna. Once you visit this place, a population of 1.4 million people. Real melting pot of cultures, they say. Just about 2,000 square miles in terms of size. As we come to the end of the Angostura LLB drinks break, both teams having a chance to set their plans for the remaining 10 overs. Aaron Pollard will know that Andre Russell is still there to come. Evening, Danny Morrison.
Good evening, Darren Gangan. I just love that little tourism package because you have spoiled us over the years on those launches, just going what, south of Port of Spain and viewing Venezuela just across the way.
Got him! What a delivery. It was the wrong on. Carlos Brathwaite couldn't respond. And another wicket goes for the Talawas.
Yeah, couldn't respond and couldn't resist. Big Carlos Brathwaite, straight after you-know-what. Light refreshments, drinks break time, and all of a sudden, another one down. And Carlos Brathwaite, he's gone for one, 63 for five.
Welcome the exciting Andre Russell to the crease. Samuel Badri earlier spoke about how he loves this opposition, the Knight Riders. Look at that strike rate. Impressive first delivery from Fawad Ahmed to Andre Russell.
Yeah, see so many of the leggies in this fabulous format go to that against right-handers, the wrong and the Google, and because of that sort of dismissal.
How often we've seen that from Carlos Brathwaite. We know the immense ability he has with the bat. We've spoken about him playing a few test matches and having a healthy average in the 40s, sort of 100 in the 50 over World Cup recently in England. Skewed from Andre Russell, and that's what the Talawas will want. Carlos Brathwaite to provide wickets, be economical, and also score runs. I'm sure many persons would have had Andre Russell on their Dream 11 team for this contest. You can log on to dream11.com or download the app.
Yeah, just looking at Kyron Pollard, on very straight, an unusual fielding position. There's he! Oh, there's an excitement up here and down on the pitch. That is a wicket maiden. 63 for five.
The variety. Again, wrist spinner creating problems for the Talawas.
look at the economy. 11 dots, one wicket, just conceding one run. Bawad Ahmed.
Narine to continue.
It's the beauty of this wonderful tournament. Two champion spinners on, having their say. Sunil Narine and Fawad Ahmed in tandem here in match six. Kalawaz under the pump hugely. Russell, so much time to bat. Say, I've seen it though. In the almighty Indian Premier League, where he's batted a long period of time for KKR and smashed it. Seen him hundreds in recent times. With a hat trick against his opposition and 100. Queen's Park Oval years ago.
Pushing hard.
For the first run. Just want to underscore the importance of Sunil Narine to this Trimbigo Knight Riders team. Over the years, we've seen him not be as prolific when he was first introduced into T20 cricket in terms of his wicket-taking ability. What he's done and what he's maintained is his economy. Most economical bowler in the history of CPL. Sunil Narine, that in itself, it's a great asset to have for any team, because you can just create pressure, put pressure on the opposition batting. And that is exactly what he's doing here.
100% DG. And then throw in the factor in recent years with his batting. How he's developed that. Instead of coming in well down the engine room of 9 and 10, he's now opening the batting a lot in franchise T20 globally. Great turnaround.
Outside edge, bravo. A little late to react. And a streaky boundary. They'll welcome this. The Talawas run scoring. It's been tough.
Ah, the frustrations for the spin wizard. Yeah, it went past. Certainly an opportunity. Went quick and low, but seen DJ Bravo take these too. And annoyingly, for the bowler, the fielding side, that has run across the very damp outfield, down through that slip cordon, all the way along the carpet for four.
Watchful, Russell. And that's because still a fair amount of overs left in this innings. Talawas scored 7 runs over, they'll get to 127. 11 runs, that is a rate that will get them over 150. Another quiet over, 71 for 5. You
don't see too many wicket maidens in T20. Previous one from Fawad Ahmed, right on the button. No, it was there, knocked over big Carlos Brathwaite. And in comes Superman, Dre Russell. Heave there. Ooh, very close to losing his castle. Superb over from this guy.
Could be out just over the head of Pollard in that unique position. exactly behind the bowler. Pollard has inserted himself. Knows that Russell, he aims to hit straight. He's trying to throw him off his game at the moment. So countering each other's strategies.
Yeah, and down the other end, you've got Glenn Phillips fighting and scrapping and showed some freedom at times throughout this innings. He's now striking way down at 109 when he's up over 160. So he's 34 from 31, finding tough going his middle stages. Sides to come to us. Fatted it clean and straight. Phillips with a hero maximum.
He's been there from the start of the innings. And I'm sure he's gotten accustomed to the pace of the pitch. Had the chance to face a few deliveries before making this strike. Well in control, Phillips.
He'll need to bat to the end, Glenn Phillips. All the Jamaica Talawas fans will desperately want him to be there for that last over. Will it have the legs to go into the boundary line? There's a chase on. Yep. Another boundary in the over. Well, this is the sort of rhythm that the Talawas might be looking for.
Yeah, credit to Phillips in upsetting the rhythm here of Bawad Ahmed. He bowled a wicket maiden previously. Because of the use of the feet, hitting clean and straight, and just sits back here, and Armour just drops it fractionally short, and it kept Colin Munro interested. He was always coming second in that race.
And again, there she goes. 50 up for Glenn Phillips. What an innings it has been. Backing up that 40 in the first game. Yeah, they appreciate this effort.
Seventh CPL half century, and I was just saying at the start of this over, he was down at 34. All of a sudden, 6-4-6. And Phillips is in a hurry now. Jeez, that's gone sweetly up into the terraces. Can we have our ball back, please? Players, of course. Oh, it's great. Gangers, back to club cricket. You've got to go and fetch it yourself. Come on, you chaps.
Spoken about a few players in this competition so far showing consistency with the bat. Shimron Hetmeyer, another player from the Warriors, two very good innings. Glenn Phillips usually amongst the runs for the Talawas, again starting the season on a good note.
Such a tough game. Wicket maiden last over. This one's disappeared for 17 and there's still one left. 17 off it. 88 for far.
Ryan has one over left in his complement of four. Harry Pierre, two. Jaden Seals, also with two. And so is Ali Khan.
Bravo usually bowls in the death overs. There's three overs remaining.
Smart by Russell. Just have a funny feeling they will be conservative against Narine because they will know fully well that this is his last over.
Indeed. See him off. was under the 14th. Yeah, happy just to pick him off a little bit. And then launch a little later on. There's so many deliveries left in the context of 2020 cricket and what Russell can do with catch-up. And Phillips is set in the half century. They could race away on two wheels, these two.
Nicely played. Just ask our statistician, Nick, to just tell me what's the strike rate that Andre Russell has when facing DJ Bravo. Spoke about how prolific Russell has been against the Knight Riders. Just wonder, that stat is probably keeping Karan Pollard, or preventing him from bowling Bravo at this stage to Russell. I'm told 215 is the strike rate. So, again, that's probably playing on the mind of Karan Pollard and Dwayne Bravo. Russell might just be waiting for the opportunity to pounce on DJ Bravo.
Yeah, throw in the fact as well that DJ missed out the entirety Hero CPL 7. Hasn't played a whole heap of cricket. Especially the pandemic globally, it's shut down a lot for players and their movements. So yeah, that'll be fascinating. See if that comes off, and Russell can just be a little bit more patient here. There's two to go. I'm soon on Orion, and that's it. Patience, my friend.
Game of cat and mouse, Danny Morrison.
A long handle too.
Lovely, Sonny.
Yeah, sees him out. Wonderful. Wonderful from Andre Russell. Just two runs from the over, one delivery left. Is this the calm before the storm?
Brilliant spell. Narayan, yet again, economical. And he had that wicket. 90 for five.
Narayan economical as usual. I spoke about that record being the most economical bowler in CPL's history. He's just consolidating that position.
Bit of do-do-do. Here we go. It's your man, Dwayne Bravo. Let's have a look. Phillips starting to get back in the groove. The strike rate had dropped to 109. Now it's back up to, well, let's call it 138.
Phillips, did he get a lot on this one? Yes. Goes all the way for Hero Maximum. Already they're attacking Bravo.
Tremendous start to the 15th over, courtesy of the Kiwi. Lots of bottom hand, and he's been in the gym during a bit of lockdown, I reckon. This lockdown, he's puffed up and got even more stronger and more buff. Glenn Phillips, always been a stocky individual, but he just looks a bit more muscular.
Taking it wide. Bravo. That's why he's been so successful, Bravo. His ability to vary his line at the last minute, change his pace. Wealth of experience, you would say, in T20 cricket.
Yeah, I just noticed there too, Darren. Is he actually followed through in that last one. Bit of effort ball, and he put it wide. And he just clutched his back a little bit there, and he's just going through a little bit of limbering up and trying to get moving, body. Pump for six, certainly a loosener, warm-up ball, and then this one, we, previous one, it's a dot ball, but just grimaced a little bit in the lower back.
Nice clean strike again from Phillips. Brings Russell on strike, so this is the matchup I've been waiting for, Danny Morrison. And it's virtually the nature of this contest. Matchup of the spinners, Lamachani, Mujib, Jens Hamid, and Narine. There you go, Bravo, just holding his side.
Licking of the lips. Salivating here. So, tweaking the field from Kyron Pollard. It was Pollard. Look at key positions. Captain is so often a boundary rider. Hot zones, you're on about long on, long off, straight. Interesting field on that offside. Two men short at cover there. Close to each other. Fascinating.
Oh, nice. A lot of finesse in that shot from Russell. And he wants to. Sure many of you will remember his 100 a couple years back. Came to the crease when his team was 41 for 5. And just enjoyed this stroke play. Kept belting hero maximums. Hitting as clean as ever, Danny Morrison.
I'm missing. Queen's Park over with a full house. Oh, yeah. Did quite like hanging out in the posse stand with the DJ and watching this guy smoke it to all parts.
Was a Superman performance from Russell in that previous game. Picked up a hat-trick as well. Scored 100. Led his team to victory. Doesn't quite time this one. Jaden Seals. Ian Bishop spoke highly about him as a young fast bowler, still developing, from Baxter Hall in Coover. His dad used to play a little bit of club cricket. Now he attends Presentation College in Chaguanas, balancing cricket with his academics as well.
Dot delivery to end the over. 15 overs gone. 99 for 5.
For 5. Ali Khan has a couple of overs remaining. Seals available for 2. Forward has one that he can offer. And of course, Bravo and Carey Pierre in there. Now, to me, this is fascinating. Absolutely fascinating, because we're talking about the death overs now. And there was one game against New Zealand, I think, in the World Cup, where the under-19 team didn't think that Jaden Seals, as talented as he is, was a good end of innings bowler. Now he's come to bowl to 2 dangerous players. And he gets away with that, because there's a short fine leg, and a little nudge on that would have sent it away for 4.
So talk about a litmus test here for the young man. certainly will feel the pressure against Andre Russell. Best bowlers in the world struggle against this man, Glenn Phillips. Well set here for the Jamaica Talawas. It's really good to see Pollard just sharing that information, that experience. I'm also calming the nerves, if there is any. But I really like to see how he goes in this phase of the game. Conversation here between the two umpires. That ball, as we've mentioned, has been really wet here at the Branagh Cricket Academy. So they're interested in making a change just to ensure that the ball is nice and dry. This is Seals, his earlier spell. Some good pace, nice bounce and carry. Just really nice areas. Impressed in the first game, impressing here again in this, the second. Despite a couple of boundaries, he was able to pick up an important wicket.
Such a different requirement for a fast bowler at this stage of the innings against players like Phillips and Andre Russell. It's a brave move by Pollard. Just as a fan of Jaden Seals, I hope it works out for him, but this is tough. Picked up into the leg side. Into the leg side. Success for Jaden Seals. This is big. That's what it means to him. What a young kid with character and skill.
Well, Ian Bishop, your hope is coming to fruition here for the young man. It's a flick here from Glenn Phillips towards the longer part of the field. Darren Bravo, well, he makes no mistake with that one. Elation for the young man. El Dorado celebration. And the second wicket for him, Glenn Phillips. He goes for a well-played 58. 99 for six.
Ramal Lewis, the off-spinning all-rounder. Now he can play, he can strike the ball. We saw that against TKR at Sabina Park last year when he bashed 37 from 15 deliveries. Smacked it all around the ground, so still challenge on for Jaden Seals. Lewis off the mark.
This is the reason why he's here. Just trying to bowl that nice tight line, and good idea to force the batsman to hit into that portion of the ground. It's Dwayne Bravo who settles under that one nicely. Another wicket for Jaden Seals. Speaking about Ramal Lewis, Bish at the toss, Rahman Powell made the point because of the number of left-handed batsmen in this TKR lineup. He was brought in.
Remember last year at Sabina Park, Hardus Filion, the fast bowler, hit Andre Russell a scary blow to the head. And obviously it was discomforted by that delivery. Wasn't as short as Russell maybe anticipated. Teams have talked about that. I like the leg side feelers. I think many teams, when we've seen, you've got Bravo on that side, quick good arm. Carey Pearce as quick as any and as strong as arm as any at midwicket. And Kyron Pollard at long on. So that big side of the ground, Samuel Badgery, very well protected by some excellent fielders.
A lot of experience out there for this TKR squad. But you could see the concerted effort. Little blip there from Tim Seifert, but you could see that effort to bowl that tight line. You have to reload that one, Jaden Seals. But coming through this examination so far quite well.
Last ball of the over. Good, very good from Jaden Seals. 104 for six. It's kind of a line that, when you talk to Jaden Seals, he tells you Test cricket is his goal. That's where he ultimately wants to go. This is his passage, his means to an end to get to senior cricket and international cricket, if it happens. Showing good versatility. Zooks fans will be very happy because they won earlier today in that rain shortened game against the Barbados Tridents. Rains came in during the penultimate over of the innings, and then five overs to get 47, and the Zooks got there with five deliveries to go, 50 for three. Nabi the player of the game, winning by 7 wickets. Had a fan of the day, Denver Anthony. Denver Anthony, BIP fan of the match. Got a right leg that feels like my left knee. Immobile. Nothing stopping them from being on fire for his Zooks, even though fans aren't allowed in the stadium. Virtual world is full of them. Good stuff.
Yeah, and good stuff here from Dwayne Bravo. Darren Ganga mentioned earlier about the strike rate of Andrew Russell against him. So he would have that somewhere at the back of his mind. But so much experience. Just 2 wickets away from being the first man in the history of T20 cricket to achieve 500 wickets, and two away as well from achieving 100 here in the Hero CPL.
You can see the meticulous nature of what Pollard and Bravo are having deep conversations, ensuring they get their field sets right. Third man is up. Deep point, deep cover, long off, long on, and deep mid wicket. He wants to stay away from the short boundary as much as he can from the leg side.
Very deliberate in what they do. This Findigo Knight Riders. Senior players. And you'll see the marked difference in fields. The field setting between these two. Andrew Russell now on strike. There'll be some unusual field placing. Because he likes to hit this ball straight. Look at where Jaden Seals is being positioned. very unusual field setting. Even the extra cover and the cover very straight. Almost next to Dwayne Bravo, the bowler there. Look at that. You don't often see that.
You probably accept that error in bowling to someone like a Russell. I know a lot of these teams, Sammy, have their analysts, the more prosperous ones. TKR have, you know, Srikant, who is very, very good and has made his name as a top-class analyst in this format. Hit that so well. He had to beat long off to his right. He had to clear Jaden Seals at that short mid-off position. Very well struck.
Such is the power of this man. Despite the field position, still manages to get it over the line, over the boundary. Just marginally off length. Dwayne Bravo. Very powerful. Dre Russ.
Well bowled, well played. 114 for six. Lots of experience embodied in that meeting between Narine, Bravo, Pollard. Ali Khan back into the attack. Switched ends, bowled an impressive spell early up.
Very well liked in these parts, Ali Khan. Very popular for the Trinbago Knight Riders. What can he produce in these very important overs?
What length? There's no deep point, so I don't, unless he bluffs Ali Khan, I don't think he'll go full and wide. Will he try to get Russell to hit into the leg side, the big side? Will he go into the pitch or Yorkers? Into the surface and gets Russell off strike.
That's a good result for the Trinbago Knight Riders. Trying to starve Andrew Russell off the strike. Not a typical sort of innings from Andrew Russell, just 20 from 23. Hasn't been able to get any sort of momentum. Still a few deliveries left. Can he finish off with a bang?
It's well bowled. Talk about Russell's power. He's hit more sixes than fours in his career. He hits a six in T20 cricket every seven balls on average. So far in this tournament, which is the ultimate way to get him to hit one, is to say that he's batted 40 deliveries and hasn't hit a six in this tournament yet. That is the clarion call for him to pump it into the seats now. Not off of that. Excellent from Ali Khan.
Could be that the bowlers have made the adjustment to him. could be the rustiness. Neither we, the Jamaica Talawas fans, they would want to see him off and running. But skillful bit of bowling from Ali Khan. Even with the wet ball, we see them drying every opportunity, ensuring that seam is nice and dry. Just to make sure that he has that control.
Excellent again from Ali Khan. Really good, and as you mentioned, with the moisture in the outfield, sometimes when the ball is damp, you'll see seam bowlers hold the ball cross seam, not with the seam down towards the target, but cross seam to try to get purchase on it.
Crucial dot ball in the 18th over, keeping Ramal Lewis on strike. They won't mind this at all, the Trinbago Knight Riders.
Slow it down, slow it down, slow down the game as bowler and captain.
All the tricks in the book. Kieran Pollard has been around for quite a while. That ball there from Ali Khan, maybe a little bit of a slower ball deceiving Ramal Lewis, but more importantly keeps him on strike. Look at that, it's rolling his fingers. Maybe he can pace off. What now for Ramal Lewis, Bish? Final delivery of the 18th. What does he do? Certainly he won't want to get a single, that's for sure.
Yeah, but deny Russell's strike at the beginning of the next over. And more appropriately, it's Ali Khan. How does he finish this over? He won't mind a single. He'd love a wicket, but he won't mind a single. So will he look to go Yorker again, which has worked for him so far, full and straight in the over? Yeah, take your time. Absolutely right in these conditions. Jeez. Wow. Well, single taken, and think Ali Khan is okay at 118 for six.
A very savage blow here from Ramal Lewis. Look at that. Wow. Good reaction to get away from that. Self-preservation, evasive action. That could have been injurious. Unfortunately for him, he was able to get out of the way of that one.
Sam Klang in the commentary box said Ramal Lewis dropped on three by Ali Khan.
Not enough tall buildings there for the Jamaica Talawas. Just that one over standing out, 13th over. Look at this in real time from Ali Khan. Smashed! Wow. Just a wow.
Dropped it. Not as dangerous for Ali Khan this time. And he'll feel he should have held on. Samuel Badri, don't say 2-2.
much easier chance this time, but might be feeling the effects from the final delivery of his last over. But more importantly for the Jamaica Talawas, Andrew Russell, he gets strike.
The pace on that, the ability to get that much power, I mean, that's as close to perfect execution as Bravo could have hoped for.
Just look at this from Andrew Russell, just squeezes that one, the bottom hand coming into play, opening the face of the bat at that last moment to get the gap and a needed boundary for the Jamaica Talawas. Want him to face most of these remaining deliveries. After we pull that one, plan for Russell, force him to score in that direction. Despite that four, want him to hit it there, so strong through the leg side, through the one side, and with the short boundaries in play here, there's little wonder that that is the go-to plan for Dwayne Bravo. So I wouldn't be surprised if he persists with that line.
Hasn't hit it nearly well enough, and Munro holds on. That is a good catch. He had to cover some ground. Republic Bank Classic from Colin Munro. Excellent plan and execution from Bravo.
A brilliant catch here from the Kiwi. Not enough connection this time from Andrew Russell, looking for the hero maximum and holding out in the deep. Well-timed slide there from Colin Munro. It's all about the timing and then the recovery. Once you get in that dropping zone, makes no mistake in the end. And the dangerous Andrew Russell, he goes for 25. Jamaica Talawas 124 for 7.
...499 T20 wickets for Dwayne Bravo, 99 Caribbean Premier League wickets. Excellent slow delivery. Ramal Lewis did well.
And he's searching for it. Dwayne Bravo is searching for that 500th wicket, 100th CPL. And this is his 499th. Really good work in the deep from Colin Munro. It's been a hallmark of this Trinbago Knight Riders team, and Colin Munro in particular. He really prides himself. I'm very disappointed with that. Not only the shot, perhaps the innings. He really didn't get going. No momentum towards it. Haven't seen Andrew Russell face that many deliveries with a strike rate under 100. 99 CPL wickets, 59 T20 international wickets, 499 T20 wickets overall. This has been outstanding. Will Fidel Edwards be that unlucky person?
So good. So good. As a slow delivery, it loops and then it dips. Even with a wet ball, that is significant skill. A few words of advice as well.
Just look at that. It loops up in the air. Then some underspin, it dips.
You'll have to say a few of that ones did really well to keep that one out. Perhaps telling Dwayne Bravo when it's his turn to bat, he won't be getting any slower deliveries. So the final delivery for Dwayne Bravo tonight, will he have to return in another match to get that elusive wicket?
He will have to wait. 500 will have to wait. 127 for seven. To Russell. Russell will get better. He's been inactive like so many of the players, but I thought they bowled well to him considering all of his skill tonight. Asif Ali blossomed briefly. Glenn Phillips has been the star so far. 58 from 42. Ali Khan to bowl the last over. Bowled again, and Pollard in the high traffic area.
Still maybe harboring hopes of 140 the Jamaica Talawas. If they can get to that, might have something to work with. Might be a tall order for Fidel Edwards and Ramal Lewis. But you have to believe, as a Jamaica Talawas fan,
too easy. Ramal Lewis wanted to run anyway to try to get on strike.
Yeah, they might just want to check exactly who is the batsman dismissed here. The bails are dislodged before they cross. Might be Ramal Lewis, and straight to that fielder who's positioned there just for this reason. So we just want to check when the stumps are broken. He's run past him. So it's Fidel Edwards who goes. Ramal Lewis remains. So another wicket for the Jamaica Talawas. 128 for eight.
Lewis on strike. Still can't get it away. They look for two. Keeper's end. Now he goes bowler's end. Good running.
It's been a real struggle for the Jamaica Talawas throughout this innings. And Lamichani, Nepalese international, just age 20. So still learning his trade.
On the ground, Monroe doing work again. Lamichana has done well to go back for two.
132 for eight. There's two deliveries left, and it has been a superb bowling performance. Karen Pollard, having won the toss, inserted the Jamaica Talawas. Well, his bowlers, they've backed that decision up with a magnificent bowling display. Jaden Seals picking up important wicket. And two wickets for 21. And Ali Khan himself with two.
Top class, you know this. This has been really good bowling, as you said, Samuel Badger. I mean, the consistency of getting the ball up there full underneath the bat with all the moisture about it. You can't speak too highly of this.
Yeah, I have to concur. And those of you looking on at home, you might not understand or appreciate how wet it really is out there. So to put on this type of display with the ball, and spinners, fast bowlers alike, is really incredible and remarkable. And one delivery left in the Jamaica Talawas innings. Can they finish off with a boundary?
Could be the difference sometimes as a bowler. You're at the top there and you say it could be the difference between winning and losing if you go for a boundary of this last ball. Really has taken his time. Again, really good. They'll come back to Tool Lamishani. He's been very, very quick between the sticks. But it has to be said, well done to Ali Khan, Jaden Seals, Dwayne Bravo, Narayan, the entire bowling and fielding group. 135 for eight after 20 for the Jamaica Talawas. Runs on the board. It's not a given. But in these conditions, the Knight Riders will think, yeah, we've executed decently.
And they'll all be very happy, elated with that performance. It's only half the job, however. And they still have to come out and get those runs. Everyone would have contributed with the ball. Impressive all the way through. Fielding as well has been spot on here. So the three-time champions, the Trinbago Knight Riders, they've done half the job. This is where we are so far. Jamaica Talawas being sent in. Glenn Phillips stands out. Andrew Russell, 25 of 26. Not really what we've come to expect. Asif Ali, 22 of 16.
Asif Ali and Phillips were the major architects in terms of partnerships. 36 between Russell and Phillips. 25 between Russell and Ramal Lewis. Look at the figures there, and it speaks volumes that in damp conditions, slippery ball, 2 for 25 for Ali Khan, good. Jaden Seals, 18 years of age, 2 for 21, bowling in tough situations, and a wicket apiece for Narayan, Fawad and Bravo. Have a look at the Digicel highlights bundle. The openers, Walton, once again going cheaply. First two games of this tournament, still a long way to go, and Ali Khan was good. He followed it up with a loosener, followed by a superb shot. But what was important was that himself and Seals were taking wickets.
Exactly the start that they would have wanted. Seals was very impressive early on. Rahman Powell came in, played some lofty blows until this happened to Dwayne Bravo. Soon as that athleticism in the field, Ali Khan again in with the wickets. Glenn Phillips continued to motor along both sides of the field, offside, onside. Continues to enjoy the hero CPL. Asif Ali, well, he too followed up his first match performance
The few lusty blows. This one off Sunil Narine. Absolutely crunched over deep mid-wicket. Glenn Phillips with the loose deliveries, just ensuring that he kept the scoring going. Until Sunil Narine brought out some magic.
Forward got rid of Carlos Brathwaite, who was stuck on the crease. But the more we see of Glenn Phillips, every year we're so impressed with this New Zealander. Finding gaps, his power, the smarts of his batting skill, quick hands. Where have we heard that before from a Kiwi batsman? Brendan McCollum sitting in the dressing room in the opposition and probably thinking, impressive young fella.
He eventually fell. The smart catch from Dwayne Bravo. Jaden Seals brought back into the attack. And try as he may, Andrew Russell got a boundary there. And another one to the offside, squeezed that one past point. But Dwayne Bravo had the final say, thanks to a excellent catch from Colin Munro. Ali Khan, the last few overs, really good. That run out off Fidel Edwards. A magnificent bowling performance. We've got Alex Jordan with an important person.
Well, what a night for the young, quick Jaden Seals out of TKR. Jaden, congratulations on a brilliant debut. First of all, we know you as a star from the Under-19 World Cup. How does this level compare?
Well, you know, it's a bit challenging, you know, coming in to play the international players, but I think with the support of the boys, I'm coping very well with it and just happy to perform for the team.
You didn't look too intimidated.
No, I think no crowds had a factor to play in that, but, you know, just going out and executing is still a hard task, so coming out and being able to do it made me feel very good.
You should feel good. Wicket on debut, 2 wickets tonight, including the dangerous Glenn Phillips. You know, the conditions, it was very wet. Didn't you struggle with the ball?
Well, initially, yeah, it got wet, but when we changed the ball, it became a lot easier for me. You know, the ball was a little harder, so it was easier to bowl what we wanted to, bowl a Yorker, so it wasn't that hard in the end.
Well, you must be very proud, but really, how must your family feel, particularly your father and your community in Basta Hall, Cuba, Trinidad?
They're extremely proud, you know. I know they're watching right now and supporting me, so thanks to my family and my community for all the support and driving me to perform and reach this far in my career thus far.
Tell us a bit about that relationship with your father. I know he was a big influence.
Well, my father, you know, he always speaks to me, gives me advice, tells me, you know, not every day will be your day, so just keep working hard and keep at it, and hopefully in the end I'll be successful.
Congratulations, Jaden. Well done.
Thank you.
And Larry Seals, the dad, will be sitting proudly, an intelligent and articulate fast bowler. Not a surprise, actually. Most of them are. There's a target, 136 to win off 20 overs, just under 7 and over. We'll take a break and have more for you not too long from now.
Didn't start that great for the Jamaica Tanawa. Chadwick Walton out early, then an LBW. Ali Khan and young Seals. Some very good outfielding. Spin Wizards were on, and they were causing havoc. Howard Armand getting rid of Carlos Brathwaite. In between all of that, Glenn Phillips. Got a half century and is playing rather nicely until then. Much deserved for young Seals. Exciting talent, this teenager. 58, the top of the innings there from Glenn Phillips. And Asif Ali with that 22. And Russell was very patient, unlike him, but he had so many overs to face at the end there. 25 from 26. And then Ramal Lewis, 15, with the standing out. Batters, that total of 135 for 8. And the bowlers, yeah, really did have a great save. Look at all the dot balls in the column here. 13-13 to the Spin Twins. 12 to Seals, and Ali Khan himself bought 11 dot balls. 2 wickets apiece for the openers, and 1 for the spinners and DJ Bravo. So very good performance from a very strong Trimbago Knight Riders outfit. And the partnership match sponsors, 9 sanitary napkins, thanks to TKR. 136 the target off 120. Fractionally under sevens. So players just going through some routines. Bit of catching. Bit of stretching. Umpires are coming back out to the centre. Messrs. Basarath and Brathwaite. A delayed start to match 6 here. A lot of rain around in the region. So the ground staff, as per, have been very, very busy, very diligent with their skills of trying to get this outfield dry as possible. Make for a fair and decent contest. If you think about the underfoot conditions. Tom Moody alongside. Runs on the board. Yeah, they would have liked a bit more, but hey, you've still got the runs on the board.
Yeah, look, absolutely. You always say that it's a pressure before you've even faced your first delivery in a run chase. But still, they'll be not totally happy with their total, the Tulawas. They just seem to lose wickets throughout that 20 overs, which always was setting them back. And they've got a very, very strong batting lineup that really didn't fire. Only Phillips at the top was impressive with his 58 off 42, but apart from that, no one really got going. This young New Zealander has a real talent at the top of the order, also keeps wickets. He's such a good timer of the ball. He loves those flicks through the leg side. And, he does give it a serious crunch. Had a couple of good years of the Hero CPL in a row, and he's setting himself up for another one. Been a real find for the Tulawas. And you'd think in these conditions with the heavy dew that batting is a little bit easier because the ball does get damp and the ball also skids off the surface. It doesn't really grip into the surface because the dew settling on top of the grass. Mendel Simmons at the top of the order. A lot of experience there. A big run scorer. And partnering him is the all-round talent of Sunil Narine. He's already done it with the ball. Can he do it with the bat tonight? It's always intriguing watching him at the crease because he doesn't muck about. From the first ball, he goes hard.
His partner at the other end, Lendl Simmons. Very destructive as well, getting on in years, in the twilight of his career. Time for the turbo countdown. We have Fidel Edwards looking out in our commentary position here. start with a bit of pace. This is the pavilion end, players' dressing rooms, and our broadcasting position. So, with Al Edwards, his first game, I've just been told, since 2015. Played for the St. Lucia Zooks. Here he is, dear old Fidel. First one up. That's a very full one.
Yeah, he's been applying his trade for Hampshire and county cricket for a number of years. Ripe old age of 38, but he's still very, very fit. Bowls with good pace. He's had a lot of success over recent years in county cricket with Hampshire. He'll be a real asset, I feel, this Talawa's outfit. He's got a reputation of taking wickets early. He can swing that new ball away from the right-handers. He certainly will do while the ball's dry. Perfect.
Comparisons there in terms of the slinginess in the arm with Ali Khan. That shape, yeah, you got to get that rhythm, get that timing in your front frame to not get it to go from the hand. You don't want it too early. You want it to go nice and late. But, the danger of the slinger's fraternity was truly, yeah, a little bit like that. And sometimes you don't quite get your timing right. You just go too early. Easier for the batsman, and also find sometimes the radar would be out. Oh, that should be out. Bit of a slip from Carlos, but he'll get there in the end. Yeah, he is. He's chuckling about it, but the first one down early.
Get done for pace by the looks of it. It skipped off that wicket very quickly. Nettle Simmons looking to pull that away to the leg side and didn't even get to the leg side. It found mid-off. Charge and looking to pull it away and slicing it to Carlos Brathwaite, who has a little bit of a stumble, unless that's a new move. No mistake with those hands, they're big. Swallows the ball. El Dorado celebration there from Edwards. Simmons goes without scoring. It's one down.
Monroe. Oh, swinging lots, nice and full. Yeah, look at the start that the Knight Riders got. Very similar, because Chadwick Walton got out early. And Jamaica were none for one as well.
Oh, look at this late swing. That's a superb first up delivery to any left-hander. You want to take advantage of this early movement before it does get into the outfield, and you can guarantee the batting side will be doing their best to get the ball into the outfield to reduce the threat of the swing.
Just a little tweak in the field. The new batter, Colin Monroe. Good movement, late at pace.
Munro is rehearsing playing straight. Just falling over that swing, stumbling towards the offside. Very, very good start from Edwards here, bowling with good pace, being the movement.
Amazing, isn't it, what a wicket does for you nice and early. Confidence for a bowler and just lifts you mentally, and suddenly the game seems a bit easier and your rhythm right. Your action's good and crease, the timing. And there is that lovely bit of swing late and you get it nice and full. Munro on his game, on his toes. And again, searching Yorker length, the swing. Wicket made and to get things underway, none for one. Jamaica were put into bat by Kyron Pollard. Coin toss. And they managed to muster 135 for 8, their turn at bat after 20. Phillips the standout. A couple of other 20s. 58 from 42. Kept the Tullawas together. And reply, very similar start. Chadwick Walton was out early. And Majeed. Oh, he's not ready. Oh, because the sight screen is... The advertising is there, so Sunil Narine says, hang on a minute, let's get this sorted. And let's get some more mileage for the sponsors. Yeah, now we can get on with it. Yeah, saw this chap, the Under-19 World Cup down under in New Zealand, Christchurch. Sunil, what happened there? So just has a bit of a brain fade. Oh, half swat. I'm sort of trying to leave it, but I'm not. And then pulls out sort of a stroke. Just to guide that red line.
He's bowling wide of off stump because he's very aware of the short boundary on the leg side to the left-hander. It's only about 65-metre hit. Down. Yes, good work, old man. Love it. He's got two fielders positioned out at deep mid-on on the boundary and deep forward a square, but it's not a big hit. And Ryan does like to play across the line and sweep slog it into that region.
He's off the mark and so's the team. There should be two. Colin Munro, what's going on? Maybe might have just been unsighted there with the players and his teammate in the way of the line.
Yeah, speaking of Colin Munro, he does like the Tullawas. He's played 8 matches against the Tullawas. They've scored just over 400 runs, an average of just a tick over 57. And a strike rate of 153. Well, that's excellent return.
And his last outing against his opposition, Kingston in Jamaica, was 96 not out. So he's dined out against the JTs. Oh, Muji. Timing, not there. Two done, one. Dozen deliveries in this run chase and just one on the board for the loss. Simmons. Fidel Edwards. looking to swing it and knock those poles over these two left-handers. And that's smarting a little bit for Sunil Narine.
Very well bowled. Full again. Swinging to the leg stump, but Narine hasn't helped himself there. He's just got the bottom edge into either his heel or his ankle.
Third man back, deep backward square on the fence. Goes the other way. Yeah, nice. Yeah, it's inside the red tram lines. He played very well last season, Moods. This was in Kingston, I believe. He's bowling beautifully. Just put a hold on seeing Colin dispatch it around the park last year. Get to that in a minute. Going well, Fidel. Oh, he just hits it to some extraordinary different parts of a cricket ground. The Sunil Narine.
Well bowled again. It's unlucky. But this is the way that Narine plays. A lot of teams do target the short ball, but this one just a little bit too wide of off stump. The line of it needs to be more middle to leg stump. Flying off that top edge for one bounce four. Done for pace there.
Very welcome that boundary. Only one so far. It's taken a while. Look at that, we've had 2.5 overs. Oh, just clubs it straight back past. Gives himself a bit of room. Yeah, nice.
He went for the slow ball. And Narine was up for it. Just hit a length and sat up. And Narine's just always set up to club the ball, whether it be through the offside or slap it down the ground. And he did the latter, did it very well. I'd be sticking to those quick Yorkers, Miles Edwards.
100%. Old Sanchu crushes a goodie. Well, here we are, Moods. Here's his innings in the season.
He's so hard to bowl to because he does play 360. He's got that reverse sweep. He does like the leg side. Very strong square of the wicket on the leg side and offside. Doesn't matter which way it comes, whether it's a conventional sweep or reverse. As we've highlighted, he's had a very, very good CPL career, and particularly against this opposition.
Yeah, that's what he does. Hugely frustrating, and look at Fidel Edwards. Three done, 10 for one. Time for more spin, so it's the open exchanges of pace and a bit of spin from the far end. Back down, where is it? There it is, Carlos. Oh, and hello. I want to see this mix up again. What was Sunil Narine doing? Because this was palmed far enough away by big Carlos, who lost sight of it. Of getting two. Incredible. Just out there at the side of the circle. Where did that go? Straight into the mitts. Oh, he's a joy to watch. He's so unorthodox at times, Sunil Narine.
But it's an interesting contest here because Mujeeb is very similar to Narine with his bowling. So I'm just wondering whether Narine can actually pick him because he does bowl the Dusra as well. He bowls not as many Dusras as what Narine does, but they're very similar bowlers and also stature. They're both tall and release it from a tall position.
Suddenly, when you have that combination of pace and spin, the power play often runs away from it. Suddenly, look at this, it's 3.3. You're one down, you're on the back foot. Batting side, you're finding the fielder a little bit. Bowler's having a say. It all seems a tough going. Going at 3.8 at the moment. The dot delivery. One to go on this from Mujeeb. Useful over. Rose right over outside off stump on his guard. Very fine over. 14 for one after four. Four overs. On the back foot here. Well, there's the Eldorado Sky Cam. Hang on. Could be an order in their moods. Ordered some buffalo wings. Don't know about you. I'm chewing the cheer leg. Starving. Hank Marvin. Get it up here. I think I've missed out on the order moods. Stick to the biltong. So changing the bowling. Mal Lewis. Now these double headers. Here in Hero CPL 8. Start of the day and the end of the day. Big old day unites. So we've got to get that early, that buffalo wings earlier. We've got to get that order in early. Asking rates climbing towards eights. Up and away. No one back there. Doesn't matter because it's disappeared. Soon on a run with a Hero Maximum.
Well, Lewis gambled. Tossed it up. Looking to turn it away from the left-hander, but just tossed it up a bit too high and a bit too full. Easy pickings for Narine. Just opening himself up ever so slightly so he can access that offside. Such a clean hitter of the ball. He does hit big sixes once he gets going. And I want to see the back of him as quick as possible.
The beauty of T20. The bowling side can be on top and all of a sudden it turns around and play catch up very quickly. Knight Riders with their batting lineup. So destructive. Oh dear, that is a bit of buffet bowling on this occasion. Talking about hungry, boundaries to the right.
But it's an interesting decision to bowl Lewis at this stage, to be honest with you. They've got plenty of other options to consider. And this has just got TK off the hook, really. They were struggling. And those two boundaries has just sort of propelled them into the 20s now. Now 24 for one. And it's not looking so bad for them that this power play. Russell himself could have been bowling this over, or Carlos Brathwaite, two bowlers with a great deal more experience. Or even give Fidel Edwards another over.
Interesting and different from Amar Lewis. One to go in the fifth. Up and over and away she goes. Yeah, races into the cushions. So 14 off the fifth, and TKR are 28 for one here.
And to Russell, he'll get his opportunity with the ball. Sweet timing. Very, very good. Colin Munro, it was a mere push through that extra cover region. The ball raced despite a damp outfield.
Good from Colin Munro. Such a sensational performer for the Trinbago Knight Riders. Really a purple patch in the Hero CPL over the years.
Good response. A bit of comparison at the end of the power play when the Talawas batted. They were 46 for 3 at the moment. Knight Riders 32 for 1. Significant difference in wickets. Colin Board to left of screen, the manager of the Knight Riders. Miscued. Such a deceptive bowler, Andre Russell.
had his problems with his injuries, his knee. The way he lands that front foot has given him problems in maintaining his balance in that follow through.
Trying to get on with it here, Colin Munro, the final over of the power play. Trying to get a few boundaries to capitalize on the field restrictions. And 12 from 4 usually gets off to a much faster start. Might be feeling the pressure just a wee bit.
Wasn't pleased with that call by the umpire. Russell, such a competitor. Had his opportunity with the bat early on, 25 from 26. Can he make a difference with the ball for the Talawas? That's the big question.
Yeah, what has stood out for me so far is the planning of the teams, more so against him. Just only 2 games, quite a long way to go, but from the early indication, preparations against him have been really, really good so far. A good start to the over, good start to the spell. 4 deliveries, just 5 runs, always seem to be carrying a niggle. Andrew Russell, he's favoring that leg of his, maybe it's the knee, maybe it's the foot area, but such an important integral member of this Jamaica Talawas team.
Ah, gorgeous. Narine again, up on one leg. The timing as good as. End of the power play, it ends on a high for the Knight Riders, 38 for 1. That's the Guardian Life power play.
Just look at that there, look at that fast arms, just through the line of it, getting that front leg out of the way. So he's basically on that back foot on contact, so still to get that power.
Mention end of the Guardian Live power play. Confirmation from umpire Gregory Brathwaite out of Barbados.
You just feel that the Trinbago Knight Riders, just the loss of 1 wicket. Ansel Narine in sublime touch, 15 the opener, 30 of 20 in this one. We've spoken ad infinitum about his consistency or lack thereof. We're sitting in this year's Hero CPL, started off quite consistently.
That was Brathwaite. It's been brought on by Rockman Paul, searching Paul for wickets. That's the only way they can keep themselves in this game. Look at that beauty. Use of the feet. Nice free flow of the arms.
He absolutely smashed here from Colin Munro. Just a shimmy down the wicket and through the line of that one. Didn't they enjoy that? Want to see some more of that. Trinbago Knight Riders, support staff and players.
Loud appeal, loud appeal. Unmoved the umpire.
possibly off the pad. Was not convinced at all. Gregory Brathwaite. Yeah, thigh. Big deflection.
Just indicating there, so off the thigh pad. Seems to be a very good decision.
Should be a single. No fans at the ground, as mentioned before, but many looking on.
Welcome to Republic Bank CPL Virtual Fan Stand, and we're bringing you by some of cricket's biggest fans across the region. Here we have Michael, all the way from Scotland. Hi, Michael.
Good evening. How are you going?
When we hit a six, how are you going to react?
Looked very excited there. Loyal West Indian supporter with his West Indies supporter's shirt. I know many of you looking at this telecast would have hoped, more so the ones in Trinidad, would hope that you could have been at the ground supporting your favorite team.
Doxum, how you fight?
Seven overs gone, 44 for one. ...92 required from 78 deliveries. This game is far from over still. Just never know in T20 cricket. Both teams are a lot of reputable T20 players. I reckon Michael has a question for us.
Sam, how are you finding the score and who's going to win the game?
Michael is asking us who's going to win. Maybe you guys out there can tell us. Sammy?
Yeah, it's difficult. It's a very difficult situation here, Darren. You wouldn't want to bet against Trinbago Knight Riders. Comfortable position, you'd imagine, with 9 wickets in hand. Sil Narine in full flow. Could this be all? Could this be all? No, it's gone over his head. Another boundary here for the dynamic Sunil Narine. Just getting enough butt on this one to clear that field at mid-off. Boundary again for the Trinbago Knight Riders.
Yeah, not using that front foot. Just swivels off the back foot, expecting length and responding well. He's raced to 35 from 22, Sunil Narine.
There's a good contest on here between these two players. I'm very familiar as well, playing together with the Kolkata Knight Riders in the IPL. A good partnership as well between these two. Colin Monroe, Sunil Narine, left-handed batsman. They like to get off with it. High strike rates traditionally.
And again. This is really good by Sunil Narine. He's taking the attack to the Talawas. And against Andre Russell, the 50 partnership comes up for these two.
Just look at that. Look at how he gives himself that room to access that offside. Almost hitting that ball on one leg. Sunil Narine, back-to-back boundaries. This over, 4-0, 4-50. Up for the Trinbago Knight Riders in the 8th over. Partnership 52.
And again.
That goes for Hero Maximum. Sunil Narine on fire. Third boundary of the over. What a way to start this run chase.
And just overcompensating here, Andrew Russell. And going down the leg side, trying to follow Sunil Narine. And a nice little swivel on that one. And goes all the way for another Hero Maximum. A very expensive over here. 14 from it, two deliveries left. How can he respond?
Surely hope you had Sunil Narine in your Dream 11 team. If you didn't create your own team, you can do so. Join for free and win prizes. Log on to dream11.com or download the app.
In 50 in the first game, exactly 50 against the Ghana Amazon Warriors. And beaten on 45 in the first two games of the season.
In runs from the over. Eight overs gone, 60 for one.
Just look at Andrew Russell there. That left boot, left ankle, perhaps. Not too sure exactly what the problem is. Walking a little bit gingerly. Catalawa is getting to 135 for eight. Knight Riders 60 for one in pursuit.
Narine 47 from 27. Munro, usually the aggressor in partnerships, just 9 from 18, providing good support to Narine.
. 76 more required. Sandeep Lamachani will now try to make an impact with the ball.
I'm curious to see how he goes. Mentioned in the first innings how difficult it was to grip that ball, that wet ball. Going in second here. All of the rain that we've had, some dew as well. I must say the spinners in the first innings did a tremendous job sitting on Narine Fawad Ahmed. The turn of the Nepalese international, Sandeep Lamichani.
Starts well. I'm sure in the planning the Talawas will take into consideration the strength of Colin Munro, his ability to score quickly square off the wicket, so that length need to be a little bit fuller.
How's that?
Innovation shown. That's the confidence that the Knight Riders have in this run chase.
So two googlies. He started off with two googlies against these left-handers. And I won't be surprised if he bowls all of his deliveries as googlies. Want to take the ball away from these two batsmen. A very good googly as well. Well disguised. Let's see how he goes against Sunil Narine on 47.
Lamachani obviously would have played for the Barbados Tridents in 2019. Assisted the Tridents, in fact, in winning the title. Had to leave early for national duty. Now he's with the Talawas.
before that. He played with the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. So he's been around the block. Lamichani, the hero CPL.
Ow!
Just making room. Colin Monroe, maybe not quite sure of the variations from Lamichani.
Some players, well, they use the latitude at the crease to give themselves an advantage. Just have a look at Colin Monroe and where he stands. Batting outside leg. Wants to free his arms, maybe to score through the offside.
Down, down.
Yeah, just there. It's an excellent first over. Just four runs from it, 64 for one. Knight Riders in full control of this run chase. Look at that red worm. More important thing, not a lot of dots on that worm. Only the wickets of Lendl Simmons taken so far by the Talawas. One required for consecutive half centuries from the Rhine.
Knight Riders fans, they'll be enjoying this. Carlos Brathwaite and switches ends, moves from the northern end to the southern end. This is his productivity so far. 15 game one, 28 deliveries, 49 of 29.
Ryan was looking at the square leg umpire as if to indicate it was a wide. Can Carlos Brathwaite pull something out of the hat? They need a wicket, the Talawas. Knight Riders, they have the luxury of overs. 72 required from 64. A lot of power still to come in this Knight Riders batting. Their captain, Karen Pollard, Darren Bravo. As we've come to know, genuine six-hitter.
Suspense continues. Three dots in the over. Naran remains on 49. We need some magic here. The Jamaica Talawas. Wickets, they need wickets in heaps as well. Very strong batting lineup, as you mentioned there. Darren Ganga and Carlos Brathwaite pull out that magic.
Another play and a miss. I made the point that teams can't find themselves in a situation where they drop their intensity, even if they're playing against a less reputable team. Remember, it's the start of Hero CPL 2020 and you're building towards peaking in that semi-final. Ryan personally wouldn't want to drop his intensity. He'll want to finish this to the end. Not a play and a miss.
This has been an excellent over from Carlos Brathwaite.
five dot deliveries. Two cylinder line. So that in itself is quite an achievement. So your mains on 49. Can he end with a maiden? Perhaps a maiden wicket. That's what the Jamaica Tallawas fans would like to see.
Finally, he gets it. Consecutive 50s for Sunil Narine. He's making this opening position his own.
Excellent stuff from the Trinbago Knight Riders champion, Sunil Narine. After 10 overs, TKR 65 for one, and it's time for the Angostura LLB drinks break.
Knight Riders need 71 from 60 deliveries with 9 wickets in hand. It's an equation that favors them. But you don't want to get complacent. The game is a strange game. Love the drone shots showing all the beauty of the stadium, well appointed. And of course, if you've been following our coverage around the globe during daylight hours, you can see the north-south highway to the right of this playing facility, Gulf of Paria and surroundings. Narine has played well. he's played some shots that I hadn't necessarily seen from him before. Oh. Misfield. Fidel Edwards, the 38-year-old. The only thing that I've been keeping my eyes on here, Danny Morrison, is the number of dot balls that have been soaked up by TKR. 40 dot balls in the first 10 overs. 40 out of 60 deliveries not scored off of.
Amazing. And to think, Sunil Narine got a half century amongst all that. Yeah, half of his just enlightened. Have been dots as well, and he's striking at 144. Yeah, I thought we were in for an intriguing reply in that when Simmons got out for Nord, it was very similar to what Jamaica did. They were none for one. But sadly for them, they lost wickets at 10, 19, 58. They were five down for 63. Oh dear. Getting tired down there, fella. That is clean and sweet. Another sixer, this time from Colin Munro. His favorite areas for this left-hander. So often see him down on one knee playing a slog sweep or a cheeky reverse sweep. Lamek Charney under the pump. Nine already off this half an over. There you go. Very good at this stroke. Now he's starting to feel and get into a bit of a rhythm. Feel more confident to do this, Colin Munro. This game will start to slip away quickly from Jamaica.
But I asked you that during just before we came on here. We were sitting over there, and that's the one shot I was saying I haven't seen a lot of. Not the slog sweep, but that, just that last paddle sweep played by Munro.
Catch!
That could be out. Brathwaite doesn't drop. He does not drop, yeah, and takes it safely. Big hands. And just as he did in the first game, he gets to a half century in the Rhine, and he falls.
Yeah, it's a unique little flick, isn't it? There's a stroke all of his own. It's that little bit of wrist work. Too much bottom hand and too much height, not enough distance. Carlos in those big mitts. Goes for 53, Sunil Narine. And the second one down by the Knight Riders at 75.
Success for Sandeep Lamashani. Darren Bravo replaces Sunil Narine. Batsman crossed while the catch was being taken, so Munro will face up to Lamashani again. Six for two.
And he knew he's in trouble straight away. It's soon on the right. Thick top edge. Brathwaite in the one.
Ahead of the rate, the Trinbago Knight Riders. I was just looking at the Narayan dismissal, and we mentioned he's played beautifully this season. But in the first game, he got to 50, and it was a similar type of shot that got him dismissed. I think he got caught at mid-wicket, though, instead of backward square leg. Doesn't take away from how well he has been batting. I think it's his third CPL half century. He was dropped by, I think, at long off, and then swept the next ball to deep mid-wicket. This was against Imran Tahir, that first inning, that first match that I was talking about. Didn't nearly take the drone out. Yeah, it was mid-wicket. And then tonight, goes again into the big side of the ground. See how far in Brathwaite was.
Now then, the Talawas, what are they going to come up with? Teams with spin and spin and more of it. So we go back to Majeeb. Pace off. Brathwaite's gone into slip. Powell, sorry.
Catch!
There it is. The old reversey. And very good indeed. Young Nicky Curtin, good effort.
It's his reaction here when he notices the ball going towards the boundary again. He's done that beautifully. Great awareness on a slippery surface. Guardian Life save of the day or the night. When Colin first came to the CPL a few years ago, he used to play a lot of those shots. Then he cut it out for a couple of seasons. Played a more orthodox role.
Yeah, and a couple of times he sort of got out at a really important juncture.
Gotcha!
Darren's underway. Bravo, that is. Yeah, and it just sometimes players go through that, don't they? Just put that back in the locker. Yeah, it can be a go-to, and it's one of the favourites, but that responsibility at the top of the order. I do recall that, Vish, saying, look, I just have to be sensible and a bit more controlled on selections as unique the starts outside off pole for the spinners.
Ali Khan was good tonight, Danny.
Yeah, after a couple of scratchy opening deliveries, the rhythm right. A really good length in conjunction with young Seals. So the pair of them in tandem, just sense they're feeding off each other. Got a wicket early, Ali Khan. It was all on.
Michael Raghunath, the match referee tonight, realize, but he coached cricket and football at Marabella Senior Comprehensive, not too far from here in Marabella in the Southland, but he was also a FIFA referee. He refereed in the 2002 Football World Cup in Korea and Japan, and also in the quarterfinals, I think, of the football involved in the Olympics in 2000. And he's a FIFA assessor of referees as well, as well as a cricket coach. So good pedigree, 82 for 2.
Very comfortable for TKR. Wanting to track down 136. 54 required, the equation from 48. It's well and truly under sevens now. It's up nearer eights for a little while. All those dot deliveries inside the first six or seven overs. More of Lamak Chani.
Oh, Sandeep. So nice, Sandeep.
Nothing outrageous. So much time to settle in here as Darren Bravo. Established Colin Munro at the other end. Luxury is there for Bravo. He says, no, I'm going to have a big piece of this one. Oh, good effort, but it was always going away too quickly. More runs.
It didn't strike me as getting all of this, not hitting it as well as he would like. Does like to hit with the spin down the ground and into the onside, Bravo. I'm doubting that the googly will appear again from Lamishana at some point in this over again.
Want to be happy? Who is our bit fan of the match? Shoya Lawrence, loving the colours, the Trini fan of note. Go girl! Yeah, bit fan of the match. Shoya Lawrence, well done. All that effort, Colin, to smash it into your other boot.
It's just the one thing I'd like to, just to perfect the game, I'd really like to have seen them make use of more deliveries in between the boundaries. Boundary hitting teams, and that's what the game is about, sixes and fours, but just wonder if they could, just in the pursuit of perfection, have been more precise in their run scoring with over 40 dot balls.
Catch!
Tries a catcher. Carlos can't get there this time. Yeah, because I hear what you're saying. You start to fall into habits, don't you? Too much of a habit. You're going about batting and the rhythm of batting, particularly in this format, does fluctuate so quickly. We know that, appreciate it. But, yeah, they got into bad habits last year, didn't they, TKR? Bogged down a lot. The other one. Wrongy. We've had 13. TKR 89 for two.
Go Fidel Edwards here, to be honest. They need a wicket. They need further wickets. And I think Fidel Edwards has the pace to be able to maybe go short at Bravo. Edwards at age 38 was swung the new ball. He bowled quite beautifully, actually swung it late, 1 for 9. But as I mentioned in the break, there's a theory that few of the batsmen from Trinidad and Tobago don't play the short ball well, the Bravo brothers included. And Fidel Edwards has tried to exploit that in times. Oh, he's back. Exploit that in times past. So, and over here, looking to go hard at Darren Bravo in particular, but not exclusively, is worth the throw of the dice.
Dime a dozen. Spot on, Bish. So, brought him back. Man with pace. Never shy at banging the ball in halfway down. And quiet. Got some lovely full stuff with the new ball in his opening spell. Here we go. Coming back for Dal Edwards. some oldies but a goodie. Naveen. Kambe, yep. Jeez, he's almost up into the 50s club with Bish. Bawad Ahmed. He's into the 40s with Imran Tahir. Rayad Emrit. And Fidel Edwards. Just a number, of course, Bish. Ages, just a number. Look how these guys can kick on because of the advent of T20 and the franchise cricket around the globe. Might see a bit of Praveen in terms of the tournament. It does get a bit drier. Just get a bit more tired.
Yeah, he's a fascinating story for some viewers who may not be familiar with him. He made his IPL debut at age 41. He worked as a liaison officer when the teams did play their IPL matches at the D.Y. Patel Bowl Seam initially, D.Y. Patel Stadium in Mumbai. We talked about playing a lot of tennis ball cricket. Really was a huge thing for Praveen Tambe when the IPL picked him up. Rajasthan Royals through Rahul Dravid and their scouting. Yeah, good. Good from Fidel Edwards.
Into the surface. Leave it a scene. Right down the line, look at it go, just a bit of angle, back end of a good length, good energy from Fidel.
Talking about back in 2013 when Praveen Tambe came to the IPL, 2013, 2014, 15 and 16 when he played there.
Think about an old dog, WA, GBH. Bradley Hogg, yeah, he'd finished international cricket, hiatus there for a while, and all of a sudden he came back in his mid-late 40s. Another crack. Enjoyed the big bash with him in it, tongue. Tearing about.
Impressive glasses as well. I'd have to go short at Bravo here. I'd have to go short at him. But I'd probably want to change the field. I wouldn't have the man at long on. I'd have fine leg on the boundary and deep forward or deep backward square.
Spoken like a true West Indian quick. Full, oh, hello, put down. Was it a chance or straight into the turf? I think it was. Big mitts, Carlos Brathwaite. Look. Oh, yeah. Definite chance. Shelled. Ricky.
Had Nelly dropped on the ball as well. There'd have been penalty runs had that happened.
Finished another over, it's 92 for two. Four required, six overs remaining, so very comfortable. The three times champions, Hero CPL in season 8, of course.
Down, down, down.
Munro. It really has been a scratchy but patient innings. Deliveries outweighing his score. Not very often for Colin Munro. Is he eyeing up now? Just a little look to that onside. Three men out in the deep on the big side of the ground tonight. He goes out there. Carves it over cover. Well played. Colin Munro. That'll feel sweet.
Just too short and well played by Munro, deliberately up and over. Producers just nudged me from the back and said if the cap has to be used on the ball deliberately or willfully in order to apply penalty runs.
Catch! Is it big? Is it big? Oh, Carlos again! Hardly ever drops it. Those mitts of his are enormous. And he got there. I thought for a moment it was just drifting away from him. But he knows he should have taken this in the end.
Many times in the last couple of days I've said Brathwaite doesn't drop many. Now he's dropped two in the space of a couple of overs. Really should have gotten himself into a better position earlier. Don't think it was anything to do with going into the lights.
Gone up, he said it's come off the glove. Look, he can't believe it. Glenn Phillips, he's spinning out. Ripping his hair out. He can't believe this. Oh, I want to look at this because he's gone with a reverse sweep. Watch the glove work. Watch the batter's gloves. Oh, did it just brush those gloves of Munro's? Phillips seems to think so. It's over the moon.
Yeah, Munro after that, after he stood for a while, indicated that it had come off his left thigh. Not that it's his decision to make.
100 up for TKR as well. These Kiwis, always trust them. Done, and it's 102 for two.
See the boundary marker move, so I'd assume that that was safe unless proven otherwise. Still doesn't look conclusive. I think it'll be okay.
Mujeeb, stifle appeal. Just 34 required from 29 now. Rob Bonpal has thrown everything at the Knight Riders. Created some chances, didn't quite get the support of his fielders. I guess, Tom, in a situation like this, you still got to have that belief that maybe a bowler can get a hat-trick and just turn this game on its head.
Well, we've seen crazy things, haven't we, over the years in all formats of the game, where you suddenly think one team is on track to an easy win and suddenly a couple of wickets changes momentum and what appeared to be a game that should have been cruised in, fall over flat on their face. So it's just over seven and over, so you would think TKR would stroll this in, particularly given they've only lost the two wickets.
Outside the off stump.
Well, all teams will have the motivation. It's early days in Hero CPL 2020 because they will be playing for this Hero CPL Championship Trophy. What a beauty. TKR, they've won it on three occasions. The Tridents twice. And to the Talawas twice. Miscued. Couple fielders getting under it. And catch taken, Mujib, bowling caught. That's a Republic Bank classic catch.
It's a very, very good catch indeed. Having a laugh about it now, but it could have got messy. Bravo looking to launch that over mid-wicket for six. Phillips had his eye set on it, the keeper, but so did Mujib. He was happy with the caught and bowl. That's very well taken. That's the third to go. Bravo goes for 14 off 17. It's 105 for three.
Karan Pollard,
big figure, strong man, wonderful strike off the cricket ball, the captain of this Knight Riders team. Very good strike rate, played a lot of T20 cricket. Karan Pollard has an opportunity here to finish the game for his team, and batting out in the middle will be something that he will look forward to. Outside the off stump.
And that's where Munro's set up, isn't he? He's batting well outside off stump. It's his way of trying to get away from the LBW. 16 gone, it's 106 for three. Yeah, he's batting about two stumps further outside off stump in his setup. Probably giving him the comfort to know that he can sweep Mujib freely without worrying about the LBW.
Dwayne Bravo. Inch closer to that landmark 500 T20 wickets. He sits on 499 at the moment. Sunil Narine would be pleased. His effort yet again with both bat and ball, another half century, another economical spell with a wicket. Well, we've seen some spectacular catches in Hero CPL 2020. Was a good outcome for the Talawas. Have a look at this. Najibullah Zadram offering a catch, and Rockman Paul holding on despite colliding.
Yeah, I think the second one, Rockman Paul, is probably the tougher of the two, even though they both were difficult, but what a tangle they got into. It was Asivali, I think, was colliding with him.
Underscores the importance of communicating, even in the field. Nice, very good innovation.
How often do we see this from Colin Munro? Using the pace and getting a boundary.
Yeah, there wasn't a lot of pace in this delivery either. It was a slower ball. Enough time just to swivel around and paddle it around the corner.
Good at all from Carlos Brathwaite. Hasn't had a very good day. Brathwaite, one off nine ball with the bat. A couple of drop chances. Remember, he previously captained the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots in 2019 and transferred to the Talawas. Absolutely beautiful from Colin Munro. Use of the feet. Still had the muscle to clear the man at mid-off. Second boundary of the over.
Slowly catching up to a run of ball personally. He had a very, very slow start of it. He struggled with the rhythm in his game. Couldn't find his timing, but he stuck in there and hung in there. And he had the benefit of Narayan at the other end, who was going very freely. So it enabled him to get in and settle. And McCullum will be pleased. He's the coach of the TKR outfit. Very pleased with this performance. They bowled and fielded particularly well to put him in such a dominant position at the halfway mark.
This one even better. Straight as a die. Good contact. And it goes all the way for Hero Maximum.
We've had 62 sixes. And this is up there with the best of them. Beautifully struck straight at the side screen. Slightly off pace delivery too from Carlos Brathwaite, just too full. It's too easy for a player of Munro's class. He moves to 45 now.
Full control of this innings, the Knight Riders. Thanks to that partnership between Colin Munro and the Narayan. Already Munro 46 was a mere bystander when Sunil Narayan was on the go. Only area he'll worry about are the dots. 25.
And that was during the phase of his game that I was referring to right at the beginning of the innings, where he just couldn't get his rhythm at all, and he kept on just picking out the fielders and he couldn't get off strike. But he had the mental strength to be able to see himself through that, not get too concerned about it.
Just over that short mid-wicket fielder. Starts his innings with a boundary. How typical, Karen Pollard.
17 gone, it's 127 for three. Yeah, it's just a big thick edge, and this is the power of Pollard and the size of his bat. It managed to clear the infield and run away for four.
It's only a matter of time for the Knight Riders to secure 2 points. They will reflect on this game and feel very comfortable with the effort in all departments. Their fast bowlers were quite impressive. Ali Khan, Jaden Seals. When you have a guy like Sunil Narine that can bowl four overs, just concede 19 runs, chances of winning, that's heightened.
Yeah, it's interesting, in a game where we thought spin might struggle, Majeep also, from the Talawar's point of view, has bowled his four overs just for 13 runs. So both of them have done exceptionally well. That might be wide.
Looks a beautiful sight in the night. Brian Lara Cricket Academy.
Tell us, Darren, about when it was built and, you know, the story behind it.
Well, it was supposed to be ready for the 2007 World Cup. And because of the delays in construction, was commissioned a lot later than 2007. And it was around 2015, if I'm not mistaken, that started to host a lot of competitive matches. There was a refurbishment that had to happen before matches could have been hosted. But it offers a different experience, Tom, to that of the Queen's Park Oval. You talk to spectators and fans, they tell you the sighting is absolutely beautiful at this ground.
It's spectacular, it really is. It's a great viewing ground. It's also a great drainage ground because the rain we've had today, I've never seen anything like it. The whole outfield was flooded completely. We still managed to finish the first game and host this game.
Things just going pear-shaped here for the Talawas. This is what Tom Moody was alluding to earlier. Just after completion of that first match of the day, we had a lot of rain. Just look at this now.
Well, when that pitcher was at its peak, as in volume of water on the outfield, it took 90 minutes before the next ball was bowled. Believe it or not. 90 minutes and they had a 5-over match to complete the first game of the day, and now you would have thought it hasn't rained at all.
Well, on Saturday we'll be back here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy for another doubleheader. The Patriots will be up against the Zooks. Zooks today getting the better of the defending champions, so he'll be on a high. And then the Warriors up against the Talawas. Second match of the day on Saturday.
It's early stages, obviously, with the table. Teams only played two after tonight's fixture, and it's all pretty even. No one's broken away quite yet. Of delay here, why the umpires just changed the ball.
Sunil Narine was on fire earlier today, opening the batting in the run chase. Two massive hero maximums. Punctuated his innings with 7 fours as well. On reflection, you would think he could have
rotated strike a bit better. Lots of dot deliveries in his innings. But he's put his team in a commanding position with that innings.
Yeah, 19 dots, but we all know what we're going to get with Sunil Narayan, and that is that you are going to get a fair percentage of dot balls, but you're going to get a high percentage of boundaries, 7 fours and 2 sixes in this particular inning. Still a strike rate closing in on 140, so you take that every day of the week, and that's why he's so dangerous and used at the top of the order, because he won't muck about, he'll get them quickly, or he gets out quickly as well, so he's not going to soak up too many balls doing it.
To his credit, he's grown a little more consistent in terms of run scoring at the top. I guess that's because of his dedication, the amount of effort he's placed into his batting. He's adapted his game from being a specialist bowler to being more of an all-rounder. Sunil Narayan. He wrote the title sponsors for the CPL. Piece of equipment to move around the island, especially in the wet terrain. Tom, are you a biker? Have you ever been?
Yeah, I've been on a bike, believe it or not. They make them this big. But yeah, not of recent years. Might have to give that one a bit of a run, though. Might get back to the hotel quicker on that.
Four required.
And that three. I must say, Fidel Edwards, he's looked in good rhythm. A wicket to him. Just conceded 18 runs. But he's 38. He's played a fair amount of international cricket. He's been playing some county cricket as well, Fidel Edwards. It's for the county Hampshire, so always good to keep yourself active in the game for you to be cutting edge. Pollard just delaying the inevitable in this situation. Will be a pleasing feeling for him as captain to know that he would have picked up 4 points from their first two matches in this competition. Might allow him a little more latitude to try some of the other players in his squad. Amir Jango, a young talented player in the TKR camp, wicketkeeper batsman.
Stuart Webster,
another young player, age 25, from Trinidad and Tobago. Akil Hussain, left-arm spinner, more of an all-rounder, very capable with the bat. Anderson Phillip in the background, right of screen, fast bowler who had a chance to be with the West Indies squad in England. Had a really good first-class season for Trinidad and Tobago.
One 34 for 3.
Everyone looking very relaxed. Dwayne Bravo might not get an opportunity to bat. He wouldn't mind that.
Yeah, probably a lot of you will be thinking, why was Pollard just blocking out the last couple of balls of that over? The only thing I can put it down to is allowing his batting partner, Colin Munro, to reach a half century. He's on 48. He's only with two required. He's probably thinking, well, I'll leave those two for my partner. He's worked hard enough out here to deserve a half century.
See if your Terry works, Tom Woody.
He's not going to block the rest of this over out, surely. I think Munro would be quite happy. 49 not out, team's won. Polly, just finish it, please.
His 13th CPL 50, Colin Munro.
Wide signal. That's the end of the game. The Knight Riders, well, they prevail in this one-sided affair. Talawas, they will have a lot of thinking to do to change that form around. This is a champion in Jim Bramble.
Yeah, it's been a pretty complete performance by TKR. They bowled particularly well, very well led by Pollard in the field. Collectively, they fielded very well as well in conditions that were quite difficult for everyone in the field, for bowlers, for fielders. We've had a lot of dew in the outfield, which does make it tricky, but they seem to be able to deal with it very, very well. And they made light work of this run chase. They've done it with great ease. Still 11 balls remaining in the innings. They've only lost the 3 wickets and they've cruised it in due to a couple of good contributions. Narine at the top of the order with a half century, and then Colin Munro finished the job to see his team home.
135 was never going to be enough for this strong TKR batting lineup. Needed something spectacular with the ball from the Talawas. They couldn't quite get that. Andre Russell tried early on. Got the early wicket in that of Lendl Simmons, but after that, the partnership between Munro and Sul Narine took all their hopes away of winning this one.
I don't know about that, but anyway.
In the end, the Knight Riders just reconfirming their reputation, their form, as they start this Hero CPL 2020 tournament. This is what the Knight Riders produce. As mentioned, Simmons didn't get off the mark. Narine was exceptional with his boundary hitting skills, 53 from 38. Munro, after watching a lot on the non-striker's end, and Narine got out, he moved into second gear. 49 from 46. Pollard just had to support in the end.
Yeah, 75 run partnership between Munro and Narine, the standout. And then a 30 run partnership with Bravo. So Munro there all the way through. Edwards, I thought, bowled exceptionally well for his 1 for 19. Mujeeb again, very good, particularly given the conditions, 1 for 13. And Lavashane with the 1 wicket for his 4 overs, just going for the 30 runs. So a comfortable win here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy Stadium. Winning by 7 wickets, Trinidad Knight Riders have cruised it here.
If you missed the action, the Digicel Highlights Bundle. Lendl Simmons played across the line of this one. Brathwaite took the catch, and then it was the Narine show, giving himself room, freeing his arms. He was very brutal,
against all the bowlers. That one from Ramal Lewis went over the boundary line for Hero Maximum. Taking the aerial route, Narine and Munro added his value as well when he got an opportunity.
And yeah, Narine's so difficult to bowl to when he's in this mood. He's got such a great ability to hit the ball to all parts of the ground and hit it a long way as well. So another half century to Sunil Narine. Then Munro took over, opening his shoulders. This was the end of Narine, just the top edge. Finished him off. Bravo joined the party in the run chase and was out there for a short period of time until he fell to this very good catch from Ajeeb.